in my videos I cover a lot of information from Freemasonry, images from Freemasonry and from Egypt. But we'll just have a look through this book. There's just a few things to look at through here. So this is more sort of Eastern artwork, artwork from around Asia of different periods. And in this plate here, among the other bits and pieces, you can see the lotus there with the tree on the lotus. And we'll just keep going through. There's lots to see, tons of similarity between the artworks here and Masonic artworks and so forth. And you can see the stairs, steps going up this way in this old artwork here, and you can also see the realms, I would suggest, the pillars, and then another realm, and then another realm going up like this. And the artwork would be from Pakistan in this case, 3rd century. And we'll just keep flowing through. A more recent artwork from Thailand here, and obviously you can see the ladder in there, the depiction of the clouds. Yeah, just similarities there with Freemasonry, etc. Another depiction here, and there is a ladder in there. There also appear to be sort of serpent-like creatures going up that ladder, similar to perhaps a pyramid of light. You can see the sort of areas around the heads here, these etheric areas, if you will, charged areas. With this piece here, just the structure of it, you have the Buddha there in the shrine, and the Buddha sort of faces out in the four directions. And you can see that with Mage Queen Victoria as well, I would suggest, where this is also, where this also occurs. Within this depiction here from China in the 9th century, within the writing here we can see the wheel turner, the universal and universal monarch, perhaps a reference to the same wheel as is depicted in Rotary, for example. But also within the writing here about it, you have reference to the guardians of the four directions, the spirit world, and the four directions, if you will, sort of these things depicted within the artwork here. And I won't dwell too much, there's a few different pages, we'll just keep going through. Again, this is the Wheel of the Law, quite an interesting depiction here. And there it is there. And you have the, in the center there, the eight around the one in the center, positioned on the lotus. In this plate here, you have that sort of alcove design, and of course we're on the lotus there, and we have the particular hand signals pointing up and down from the, I would suggest this has to do with the etheric energy that pours from the hands, and you can see a little sort of a portal there on the hand in that case. More hand signals. This plate would be from Cambodia or Thailand, Angkor Wat, or Angkor Wat style. In this Buddhist depiction here, let's get a bit of a date on it, 1886, Upper Burma. And there are pillars there, pillars of light, I would suggest, just as you would see in Freemasonry. And there is the serpent, but it's a fish. with its tail in its mouth. Similar depictions. Here we have a depiction of a fiery hell, I think this one is. This is from Burma, a recent drawing, but it's interesting to have this configuration here, and these are perhaps the pillars here, the elemental pillars represented at in the around here in the four directions. And over here we have yet another plate. Again we have the air, water, earth and fire around the center here, the magic circles, the pillar of light depicted, and further realms here within the artwork. Planet deities, this is from Central Asia, the 11th century, and of course the notion of planetary deities is not just an Eastern thing, it's also a Western, if you will, notion. The deities of the planets and the sun and the moon, etc. This one here is perhaps the sun, and this one here is perhaps the moon, with the fiery Buddha, the Buddha of fiery radiance just here. This one's from Western Tibet, on the lotus here with the hand signals. And this one shows the tree, this plate. Let's just get an idea of where it's from, the 19th century recent. But the lotus and the different realms here with the stairways sort of going up through, and the tree, the sort of structure through the center, if you will. The clouds with entities on them. Same sort of thing you might see, you know, sort of depicted in the Christian church. Here, this plate would be from Cambodia, 12th century, and you have the serpents here, and also here sort of flowing through the body, if you will. Here you have a sort of a mandala type configuration with what I would suggest is the magic circle here, and the lotus configuration. And you have entities here within fire, sort of fiery entities, if you will, depicted. Etheric fire, I would suggest. And this one's from Japan, this plate, from the 15th and 16th century. And we'll keep going through. Another sort of plate here. This one would be from Tibet, a reasonably recent one. You have a depiction down here of the tree and clouds and deities on the clouds, these sort of different levels, if you will, different realms, different various dimensions depicted. And this one is of a mandala, and the description is here, 14th century, and I think quite clearly in the center here you can see a representation of earth, water, air and fire around the spirit in the center, and you have the four around the one configuration here. So that's just some basics, just having a look at the artwork within this book here, and the similarity between this and many of the other things that I show.